You all like, have you all seen Lord of the Rings?
Yes.
I've never heard of it.
Yeah, what is that?
I watched all of them not too long ago, yeah.
How, J. Longbone, Lord of the Rings, go. Oh no.
I have a vague remembrance of it when it first came out, and that's it.
Back when they came out in theaters, I wasn't too into them for some reason. But recently, my friend was just like, "Dude, you gotta watch like the not just the theatrical, but the extended ones. They're so fucking good." And then I did. And by the time the first one was finished, I was like, "Put on the next one," even though it was like 1 a.m. I was hooked at that point. I had to finish them all.
They really are so
very good. Very good movies.
Yeah.
There were dragons and a man with a pointy hat on a dragon.
Yeah.
How about 6 Reasons Lord of the Rings is Racist from Cracked?
Oh, yes. Right on.
I mean, I'm sure
I consider myself an expert in racism.
Hey, there you go.
Excellent. Well, we've already got our SME. Let's go.
Jesus Christ. Oh my god. Okay. Does anyone know anything about Cracked? I feel out of the loop on this one. They're like a...
It used to be a magazine, and then they turned themselves into a website. Then they got involved with that Facebook money, and they started moving everything over to Facebook, and now I don't think they exist anymore. I actually used to read Cracked, so...
Yeah, I like Cracked, too.
Yeah. Or did you say Cracked?
I like
Cracked.
Cracked was a mad ripoff. Yeah. It sucks.
Oh, and Cindy wanted
yeah,
to say...
Yeah, it was. That's true.
That
That's
animation garbage. Took... 2 weeks. With...
I just refused to read it on principle.
That animation.
Give me. I need my Alfred E. Newman fix.
That animation took 2 weeks to make with plague coloring the frames and no sleep. I almost died. It's like, well, I'm not gonna say it was worth you almost dying, but holy shit, was it awesome!
Super good. Super super good. Loved it.
Yes. All right. Here goes.
I think I've seen this video before too.
So sorry.
Oh yeah, I have. I remember these two retards.
Is there like a triangle of predator dots on my forehead, or what's...
You look like you want to talk about Lord of the Rings.
What about me right now, sitting here, doing work, tells you that
Isn't
I want to talk about
that? Isn't
that
the guy with the channel? He made that video about how cancel culture isn't real.
What is the argument for that?
Oh god.
Shit.
Because celebrities aren't fully canceled, what? That means but cancel culture isn't real. But like he fails to realize that cancel culture is a culture in which people think it's necessary to cancel people over bullshit. It's a culture. It's not about how it's carried out. He's a fucking idiot.
Also, the idea that, like, hey, they're not dying in a gutter without any possible works. Like, yeah, I mean, okay. I guess they didn't get that
they're
result.
They're beating him with a bat. I was like, well, he's not dead.
Yeah, I made this comparison. Like, people think rape culture is a thing, in America at least. And I was like, okay, so if all women in the world aren't raped, that means we're not in a rape culture, right? Is that...
Yeah,
we're
going
to use that logic.
Which I don't think they would want to use. They'd be like, "Ah, no. It's a different one, different rules."
You're wearing a shirt. You were going to wear shirts.
Pretty sure he doesn't. Like, at least according to all the fan art I'm familiar with.
You ever notice how these movies are all about religion?
Yes, I do know that Tolkien and C.S. Lewis were devout Christians who put...
Did you say Tolkien?
Tolkien.
He is very familiar with the source material, I see.
First off, it's Tolkien. Second, they were Catholic. Third,
Christian.
Yeah, but it's like that. You know, there's enough of a distinction that Catholics feel the need to make that distinction.
It's like saying Baptists aren't.
I'm not going to disagree with you. I'm just saying. And three, Lord of the Rings does have Christian, yeah, that Christian influence, but it is not based off of Christianity, or at least it's not about Christianity, unlike Narnia, which is a literal allegory for it.
Who's Aslan? Is he Jesus?
Oh, which biblical figure is Mr. Tumnus?
I don't fucking care.
The great three-headed Hydra? Is that, yeah? That's the Bible, right?
Well, they have to go into they have to hide in a closet. Was they have no a wardrobe. Oh, if it's a wardrobe, it doesn't the joke doesn't work.
Damn it.
Excellent.
But it's thinly veiled Christian themes in all of their works. Speaking of, I would love to get back to that thing. Work?
What work? You're sitting over there drawing penises on hot dogs.
I didn't think you could see that.
Wow, that's so anyway, funny.
That's hilarious.
So
drawing penises on hot dogs. That seems. You know what I mean? I'm trying to picture like you getting hot dog pictures from like Google and just drawing. What are you doing?
Buns he's ever gonna see.
Weird.
Just rehashing. I'm talking about how Lord of the Rings deliberately and willfully takes a big old hobbit poop on every major religion except Christianity.
Oh, you know hobbit poop is so stinky.
It does?
Not even true, but okay.
I guess we'll have to see what they say. That's a weird one.
Alright.
I'd be shocked how you'd find Hinduism, Buddhism. I don't even know how you'd fit Islam in there unless you're going to say, oh, black people are Muslims, even though that's not a thing.
It's hey, only partially true. We saw the one black Gondorian in Return of the King, okay? Who's there?
This is like the worst humor I've ever heard.
Since one of the major religions in the world, right? First you got the hobbits. They're clearly pagan earth worshippers there.
No, they're not.
What are you talking about? Okay, they're clearly pagan earth worshippers. Let me stop you there. No. Carry on.
where did you even get this?
They're pagan because they live in holes in the ground. You know, like pagan earth worshippers. They who live in holes.
Pagans
in the
live under the ground, right?
They worship their houses, is what you're saying?
During Halloween?
I mean...
That's how they do it. You're looking at me like something weird or something for just letting you know that pagans sprout from the ground on Halloween.
It's not about where you came from. It's about who you are.
Pagan earth worship.
Endless housing, they smoke weed every day.
The finest weed in the South.
I didn't realize that smoking weed was pagan.
I like how they put that clip in there. Like, did you know that they smoke weed in the film? I need you to see this clip.
Otherwise. It's also not literal weed, but.
No, of course. That's what I mean.
No, they talk about pipe weed. Pipe weed.
Fucking crazy smokers, dude.
Pipe.
Heck on that religion, though. It's basically a utopia. I'm pretty sure Token would love to live in one of those igloos.
Token, stop it. Please.
This is his token.
Token, get it? Because they smoke weed? Token?
Oh my god.
Oh, hey!
Learn how to read.
Spot the connection, nice.
It's Tolkien, right? You pronounce the I?
Tolkien.
Tolkien. No, that's the verb. When you're writing a book, you're Tolkien.
And smoke weed every
sure, but the movies constantly remind us the importance of having a strong will. And the hobbits, as nice as they are, they just don't really have that. The only reason Frodo
What are you talking about?
The most resilient to the ring don't have strong wills?
How could you watch the films, see what Sam does and go, he doesn't have a strong will?
Hey, Sam's just really a piece of shit when you get down to it.
Interesting take. Just because you want to chill in your little hobbiton with your weed and your beers doesn't mean you don't have a strong will.
Like, well, they're super stubborn about staying too.
Yeah, they're like, fucking leave us alone.
Yeah, like,
you know, like those pagans.
Those stubborn weed smoking pagans.
Face.
Frodo is all the way to Mordor with the ring is because Sam is there to pick up his slack, and neither of them would have left the Shire in the first place if Gandalf hadn't have made them.
No, he doesn't force them to. They totally. I mean, you could maybe argue for Sam,
Frodo
but like, Frodo accepts. Yeah.
Even when they get to Rivendell, like he's kind of, you know.
Going from Rivendell, yeah. They all volunteer.
He's down with the sickness.
Gandalf does not make them leave the Shire. There's only two choices: run away to safety or stay and die. That's not much of a choice. Gandalf just put them in the right direction to hopefully not die.
Dude, Gandalf forcing shit, man.
We're not.
There's
even
a war.
Well, I guess this is going by quickly because they're too stupid to actually make arguments. They just say shit and hope that you agree with it because they're little.
Well, they're doing the thing. It's like if we get super broad and pick random pieces out, we can make it look like something else. You're like,
Fucking pagan earth worshippers, and he just doesn't even begin to qualify it.
or it's kind of understood that the Hobbiton would be annihilated. I mean, they're a naive, innocent people whose beliefs are nice and all, but they're not the chosen people. Frodo gets to go to heaven and they...
What are you talking about?
They're not the chosen people? What?
Does he mean, like, they're not elves in that sense? Or, like...
I guess so.
What does he mean?
These
the age of the hobbits is upon us.
This is a weird one.
Exception to the rule. Mm-hmm. Through good works, he regains his divinity.
This is starting to sound a lot like church.
Through good works, he regains his divinity.
The band?
No, not the...
Is that... That's a thing with Frodo? Through good works, he regains...
That, I want to hear what he said. I couldn't hear that.
...and all, but they're not the chosen people. Frodo gets to go to heaven in the end, but that's the exception to the rule. Through good works, he regains his divinity.
Well, that's not why he goes to the Undying Lands. He goes there because he was a ring bearer. It's a...
Yeah, through his good works, there you go. Totally, there you go.
Mm-hmm. I mean, that's... Sort of, but...
It's not quite the same thing as heaven in the Christian sense. It's...
That part fits in with the Catholicism.
Does that qualify Sam as a ring bearer then? What does it mean to qualify?
Yeah. Well, Sam does go. He, as a ring bearer, he does eventually go over there too. But the implication, or at least what I'm reading from what he's saying, is that the implication is that pretty much no one except for Frodo is going to go to the Undying Lands, as though it was like exclusionary heaven or whatever the hell, but it doesn't work the same way. I'm not exactly well read on this because I haven't finished the Silmarillion and I only read like the first 50 pages and then stopped.
Well,
there's probably someone who knows more than me, but I know it's not the same.
Well, according to chat, Frodo wishes he got his finger cut off and he can't play the guitar again.
Oh.
A lot like church.
And speaking of the chosen people, what about the dwarves?
The band?
No, not the... Why would I suddenly be talking... No. The dwarves in Lord of the Rings, they're like anti-Semitic caricature of the Jewish people.
What are you talking
about? All right, so, my dude, right. I'm gonna lay this on really thick for you. If you look at a dwarf and you think Jew, I don't think that the issue is with the dwarves, per se.
Yeah,
I think have some deep-seated Semitic attitude that you need to work out with yourself.
It's a bit of a projected leap, for sure.
Wait, so the dwarves are the chosen people?
I'm
actually shocked.
The elves are going to be the chosen people, right? I'm assuming?
I assume so.
The dwarves are the Jew, right? That's... Of course, because they covet gold and shit, right? That's gonna be okay.
Short, hairy, gold-loving, giant noses
yep,
with legs
would
chase out of their sacred homeland because their avarice made them dig too deep. They're like little Nazi flashcards, at least the ones that managed to survive the mass extermination.
Okay, I'm gonna share with you a little story. So, I don't remember if it was exactly someone in the Nazi party or the Nazi party specifically. I might be misremembering it a little bit, but someone affiliated with Nazis sent Tolkien a letter saying like, hey, will you support us in our hatred of Jews? And Tolkien wrote them a letter saying, you know, fuck yourself. He was not anti-Semitic and he would not have made this as a caricature.
But they like gold and have big noses. It's clear.
And it's clear that he's reading into that, so clearly I think the stereotype is on this guy.
No joke.
Oh my god, is he gonna say orcs are black people? Please?
Oh my god.
I bet he does! Holy shit, I bet he does!
Your bets, everybody! Place your bets!
We do have... Apparently it's racist.
So. Yeah, I'm going right on that. I'm saying...
Crack thinks dwarves are Jews. Who knows what they think orcs are?
Extermination of dwarves... That happened. Sound familiar?
You're grasping a little bit.
Oh, am I?
A little bit.
They weren't exterminated.
Oh my god, it was... No, it makes sense. It was done by the Balrog, which is super fiery, just like the ovens at Auschwitz.
He's like a big walking
allegedly.
Oven.
He's trying to say that like the dwarves were almost exterminated. The dwarves were not relegated to this one mountain.
Yes, they were.
Yeah, because they were all in Israel.
This is a stupid question, but I just want to be clear. This isn't a satirical position they're taking, right?
I don't know.
No, this is absolutely not.
I don't know what to make of it. because it seems like it would be like The Onion, where whatever their headline is or whatever the name of a video is, you're meant to interpret it the opposite way. But like, no, when they're actually making this argument that
they're actually making, yes, 100%. When they started doing these videos, they were very serious. This is actually an argument they're making, 100%.
Fucking hell, dude. Okay.
Great. The dwarvish language that Tolkien made up is based on an ancient Jewish tongue. It's a direct quote from Tolkien. I do think of the dwarves like Jews.
Why do you keep saying Tolkien?
I would love to see the context of that statement that I do not trust.
The thing is like there's a whole bunch of quotes that people always take out of context, like wildly out of context.
Hey, what's the question that led to him answering it and saying it like this, you know?
Was it included in that rundown there? Oh, we can't see shit. Cool.
Yeah, we can't see the question, we can't see the rest language of the
language that Tolkien made up is based on an ancient Jewish tongue. It's a direct quote from Tolkien.
Okay, hold on. Just basing it off of another language does not mean shit, because a lot of The Lord of the Rings was also based on Norse mythology. Like, almost all of the names for shit he pulled directly from Norse mythology and Beowulf.
At once native and alien in their habitation, speaking the languages of the country but with an accent due to their private tongue. So, he's not saying it in reference to anything other than they are native and alien in their habitations, speaking the languages of the country, but with an accent due to their own private tongue. That's all he means in reference to?
You could take that whole sentence and switch Jews for Amish, and it would still be 100% accurate.
There's a good chance that he would agree with that. Yeah. Well, this is what I mean. If you just take that part out, then you can make it be about anything.
Yeah, this doesn't... I don't see how this is different from taking any aspect of any culture and using that in some way for a fantasy world, which is done all the time.
Even if we go strictly by what they're saying, like, sure, let's assume that the dwarves are allegorical for Jews directly. The dwarves are portrayed as the good guys in both The Hobbit and The Lord of the Rings, so what exactly is your point?
Racism. I'd love to know what they think of the goblins in Harry Potter.
Oh yeah, there's the thing that happened recently Peruvians. About Alien and Predator being racist.
Oh, yeah, I did see that.
Okay.
Yeah. the aliens represent black women.
Yeah, right. they're impregnating the world, yes.
Somebody in chat said, Tolkien stated he wanted the dwarves to have a rich history and culture ingrained with them, hence he picked the Jews. Not that they were physically based off of them, etc.
Too late, they're gold.
No, they like gold, that's it. Yeah.
They like gold! I mean, I love gold, but I'm not a Jew.
That's a reference to Gold Member, I caught that.
Gold Member.
I love gold.
I do think of the dwarves like Jews. End of quote. Full context.
Okay.
Oh, so they are fucking around then. They must be fucking around.
They're not. I'm telling you, they're not. I remember watching and reading these things years ago. They are not fucking around.
Sounds like they want to straddle the line between we totally mean it and we totally don't, like plausible deniability on both ends.
Yeah.
Like I say stupid shit in a funny voice.
Not you.
Although I would say it is risky for a publication like them to be anti-woke. I don't know.
Yeah.
Because there's money to be made right now in like turning woke, and then, you know, one satirical website now becomes this site where the headlines they published are in complete earnest. This is hard to believe for me, but I don't know. Yeah, that it seems to be on the line. I really don't know what to make of it one way or the other.
But like the fact that you just said full context when you could pause to see it wasn't, don't you think?
That just makes him a liar. Doesn't mean he's trying to be satirical or doing parody. It just makes him a liar.
Yeah. I concede you have some sort of point there, but like, what about Muslims and Hindus? Two of the biggest religions on the planet, and I don't recall seeing...
The Easterlings.
That's a made-up word. You made that word up.
The Easterlings, dark skin, they ride the giant elephants, they look like evil dervishes.
Oh, yeah.
They don't look
like
evil.
Racist police sketch of anyone living in the Middle
East. You think they look evil? What is that? What are you saying there?
They look like soldiers.
Yeah, see, this guy's injecting a whole lot of his own personal biases into this.
Look, there's even a scene in the Two Towers when they first meet Faramir where he looks at one of the guys he's killed with an arrow and he's like, man, it's a shame that war brought this guy so far from home just so he could die here. Like, that's really shitty. I wish that didn't happen, that yeah. thing. But, okay. All right.
Middle East or India. They're technologically advanced, but they're in cahoots with the wrong gods, so they can't be trusted.
Okay, but no, like, racist white Christian thinks that Muslims have all the technology. The stereotypical evil Muslim has, like, a long beard and lives in a cave. Maybe it's dwarves again.
Tolkien was a student of medieval history and literature. And if Robin Hood, Prince of Thieves taught me anything, it's the Muslims during the Crusades had things like math and telescopes that just confounded all the white people.
Is he literally...
That's not a real... But that movie's wrong.
Wow.
Okay, now I do believe this video is trying to make it like a definitive point now. This is such a weird video. Yeah, no,
seriously, they're taking it serious. They were like some of the early woke publication.
The exchange between those two guys is really awkward because it's written, it's like pre-written, like as a script to sound conversational. Mm-hmm. In which case, I don't know why they don't just sit down and like, not write anything, just have an actual conversation and record it. But it's like they wrote this out first as if this was supposed to be funny to watch. I don't really.
All of their videos were like this. All of
them. Oh my God. Good Lord.
Well, never take Jerusalem. Tolkien's version of Muslims have a bunch of real.
People are saying Shad is triggered. Is Shad in chat?
not to mention, he keeps saying that these guys are Muslims. Where does it say?
Well, they look evil. Didn't you hear him? They look evil.
Wait, so they're brown and they look evil, therefore they're Muslim. Yes. I wonder if that says something about you, not about the film/books.
Oh, Shad is there. The problem is we're already stacked, and this.
I'll just jump out.
No. This is.
You got nothing to say anyway.
No, this is much. This is like four of the people.
I don't even know what Lord of the Rings is. Who the fuck is Jer Tolkien?
No, shut up. Don't you try it. I see you trying to escape. There's seriously a lot of people that are still waiting to come in and stuff. So like, I want to make sure we get a decent chunk with as many people as we can. Don't worry, Shad. This video is awful.
Really awesome shit, but their souls are still corrupted.
Who are the Christians then? Humans?
No. Wrong. The humans are atheists or agnostics. Basically, all the people that stop going to church. Because when they should.
All the people that stop going to church.
Stop going to church. What? It doesn't save you any time to just say they just don't believe in God. Does they stop going to church? Well, that includes theists. What a strange way to describe them.
Yeah. Again, please show supporting evidence. Oh,
look, this is Aragorn opening doors. Isn't that enough for you?
Just like atheists open doors.
I wonder if perhaps religion wasn't the main part of the story, either the book or the movies, and therefore it was not relevant to the current plot. And maybe you're reaching across the planet.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Mm-hmm.
I don't like this video.
No.
I'm not convinced.
I guess I don't hate it as much as I hated Cinema Virgin's video, but.
Oh, yeah. You know. I imagine all of EFAP is curious to hear your thoughts on that video. I don't know.
Oh, should I do that now or should we wait until the video's done?
I assume now the mere idea of you giving your thoughts on Cinematic Venom's video.
Cinema Virgin.
He clearly fucked the dude at the end, so that can't be true.
Yeah, you missed the gay sex? Like, what the fuck?
He simulated it. He was not into it. You could tell.
So, what did you think of that video, Wolf? Tell the people.
Okay, so, I know that I am seen as the most facetious of probably anyone that has been on this show, much less hosted.
Really?
People think I'm pretty hyperbolic and all that shit.
God's different.
Shut the fuck up, Rags. I'm not dealing with your shit tonight. So, I'm maybe a little bit hyperbolic on some things, but I gotta say, of literally every YouTuber I have ever seen in the decade plus that I've been using this website, I have never seen anyone worse than Cinema Virgin. I would consider the worst by far.
I mean, it was pretty bad. I will give it.
Wow.
I'm going to quantify this and or qualify this rather in such a way that is indisputable. First being that he didn't get a single fucking thing right in that entire hour and a half of worthless garbage ass video. He literally stretched so far that he couldn't even manage to pluck a point that made any level of sense. Not even like it's insane to me that he managed to make that video without even addressing the points that most people make that are still almost universally incorrect. I don't know. Like, first off, drop the whole attempt at being Doug Walker, because aside from him not being a good YouTuber and never having been a good YouTuber, it's not someone you want to look up to. You're also not funny in any respect, or intelligent for that matter. Couple that with your inability to make a single cogent point with any supporting evidence and your willingness to accuse the entire EFAP audience of insulting your family that doesn't exist.
And wait, what?
He said that the EFAP audience was attacking his family.
Oh, yeah, I don't believe that.
I wouldn't believe that for a fucking second.
Well, I don't believe it because I don't believe he has a family in the first place.
What, you think he paid for that house on his own?
Well, you know, that's all up to your subjective interpretation, of course. The fact that you act like a little bitch when people insult you, when you insulted people it like every 5 minutes of your video, goes to show what a spineless loser you are, a complete tool. You need to get some talent before deciding to make YouTube videos or anything else for the rest of your life. And you need to shave off that disgusting hair. Please. Please. This is a PSA to anyone who has thinning hair or receding hairline. As someone who had both and then shaved it before it ever got bad. So you will save yourself so much self-respect if you just shave the damn thing off rather than pretending like it's ever going to get better. It's really embarrassing when you keep it there and perhaps hide it under a beanie, or don't hide it at all, or proudly present it while you are simulating gay sex with your weird pseudo boyfriend, whoever that dude was.
I don't know what that was. Either.
It's an odd one.
So please just shave it off. You're not going to gain any intelligence from it, unfortunately. I think you need to go back into the public school system, or any school system for that matter, to gain that. But yeah, I guess I could rip into you, but I'm just too tired to do that.
That's not ripping into
him. You know, that was very reserved for Wolf.
You sound like my wife when she talks to our cat.
The thing is, I would have had to have been in that call, because I'm probably forgetting so much shit that was in that episode that, for the most part, the guys broke down pretty well, aside from forgetting a few things they could have brought up, and their insult game wasn't half as good as mine would have been if I was there. Not to disparage you, but man, I would have made this person cry and then complain about his manic depression. That's another thing. Don't tell people you have manic depression as a get out of jail free card, aside from it being just pathetic on a level that not even a child would go to, because they wouldn't know what manic depression is in the first place. It's just really sad that you would use that after insulting people consistently. You can stop your pissy little snipes on Twitter acting like a 5-year-old, pretending like you have any say with your audience of 4 people who actually give a shit about your god-awful content. If you decide to delete comments that are literally just constructive criticism and pretending like people are attacking your non-existent family, you make it a little difficult to sympathize with you. Kind of like it's a little difficult to sympathize with a guy who pretends like it is body harassment to ask why he's wearing a jacket indoors.
Well, there we are.
All right, there you have it.
This is the thing. Surprise,
react to that last part.
If memory serves, did he actually make a point? Like a good point, Rags? Do you remember?
I'm trying to think if there was a point that he made that was legitimate, or at least could be like understandable. Like wrong, but still, you know, you understand why a lay person would be like, oh yeah, it's a problem that they didn't ride the eagles to Mordor. And then you just explain it to them and they go, oh.
So I'm I don't think anything to them would work.
I don't think so either. Aside from
basically screeching in a tree about how much he's very disturbed by the gaze. You know, I don't think there's any way we can
The gays are pretty spooky, come on.
I love how he's like, guys, I'm totally not homophobic. I just really don't like the gays for some strange reason. I would like it if they were openly gay, but because they're literally not gay, that he doesn't make sense. Oh, that's another thing. There were so many things in that video that didn't make sense. I love how he tried to quote unquote call out Peter Jackson for not including like the most irrelevant character in the entire book series that absolutely no one in their right mind like actually cares that he wasn't there. He didn't even not Tom Bombadil. Like not even a character who I even remembered the point of being in the book. Like it would make sense if he said Tom Bombadil. The problem is that he's too stupid to make sense. So he didn't reference. I don't know. I genuinely don't remember who it was. It's like I can think of like the two people that led Pippin through Minas Tirith in the books. They weren't in the movie. I didn't think it was a big deal, but I can understand why people would be a little disappointed in that. And then he didn't even reference Tom Bombadil. He referenced some other guy. I don't even remember who it was. Not Haldir, chat. He.
Someone said Horn Guy.
No, Haldir.
Erkenbrand.
I think it started with an H, but I can't remember. I'd have to go back and rewatch the video. But yeah, it was really strange that he would make that argument when, like, 20 minutes earlier, he was like, I didn't like the books, and y'all didn't think they were supposed to be in there anyway.
You sound like Bernie Sanders?
There are some who call a dwarf.
Also, fix the hole in your wall.
Did you
Jared.
Like that his favorite characters were Lurtz, the Rig Wraiths, and Crema Wormtongue? They were his three favorites.
Oh my god, dude. Ugh, fucking Harry Potter. I don't have that much against Harry Potter, but after watching that video, I now hate Harry Potter and everything and anyone associated with it.
Yeah, I can't say I'm the biggest fan of Harry Potter after that.
Yeah, it's like I didn't even really have anything that much against it. Now
it
I
weird.
Do.
He kept appealing to Harry Potter. It was really weird.
It's the only movie he'd ever seen.
At least Harry Potter means something.
Are you talking about the franchise broadly or just the books or the movies?
Oh, it's just that he kept bringing them up as like a counterpoint to Lord of the Rings. Like, hey, this is what Lord of the Rings does. Look at how Harry Potter does it better. It was like, what? Stop. What did that
Sorry, right, yeah.
do anything better than Lord of the Rings?
Yeah, I mean, I don't even know what you would compliment Harry Potter over Lord of the Rings. It's like, he was like, Harry is a better character than Frodo. And it's like, why are we doing this? Why is it? What's this?
Oh my god, and the Gimli wanted Frodo dead. You have, like, I'm not reading comprehension, the perception skills of a fucking dead goldfish. I don't know how you managed to listen to that quote more than once, unless you didn't watch the movies, which is probably the case, and ever come away with the idea that Gimli wanted Frodo dead, and that he listed that as a criticism. It didn't even call out why that would be a inconsistent part of the character.
It's an odd one.
He didn't even justify his wrong opinion on anything.
Well, he tried to justify the Gimli thing. He went through the quote and the scenes, like, and he got it totally wrong, but he tried.
It's one of my favorite things ever. It wasn't a casual thought. It was, no, I checked. Gimli wants them dead.
Okay. Double check to make sure.
Calling Bilbo Dildo.
It's hilarious, though.
It is so funny, though.
Oh, wow. It's so creative. Right. He replaced the B's with D's.
Wow. I'm gonna play some B's.
Truly, like, galaxy brain jokes there. I'm pretty sure I would have died of a violent aneurysm in the middle of streaming if I was with you guys. So it's probably good that I wasn't there.
Excellent.
Yeah, I know those are some very scrambled thoughts. I thought of actually writing something out, but then I was like, no, I probably shouldn't do that, because that would just be like getting back into like the reason why I left YouTube in the first place. So yeah, your video was awful. You're awful. Your attempts at sniping at Mahler repeatedly because you're too much of a sour little pussy to come on the show and debate your terrible opinions go to show what a insignificant weasel of a human being you are. And I'm only glad that no one cares enough about your shitty YouTube channel to actually give a shit about this failure of a feud you're trying to start based on your awful video.
You went after Lord of the Rings. Wolf doesn't like when you do that.
I don't like you as a person.
And I'd like to confirm that this was you taking it easy on him?
Yes.
This is me, like, not giving enough of a shit to really collect all of my thoughts. I had an Alfredo pasta when I asked for a marinara.
Marinara pasta!
I have a 2 liter of cherry Coke when I wanted a 20 ounce of cherry Coke, and they didn't even bring me my goddamn Parmesan bites.
Wait, isn't the cherry Coke thing kind of all right? Because you got more cherry Coke than you were expecting?
That's not what he ordered.
I don't know, Rag. I already had more than I should have had today in the first place, so I only wanted the 20 ounce, so then I didn't have to drink all this, which means I'm going to have to probably throw this away.
Put it in the fridge!
No, I don't want
to. Yeah, we have these boxes that are cold inside. You could save it for later.
And you know what? I'm even more disappointed, because I was like, man, this would be great because I'm on the stream tonight, and then I ate that disgusting Alfredo shit because chicken, sausage, and pepperoni do not go with Alfredo. And then I ate it, and I was like, wow, I really regret doing that. And now I'm just like, well, what do I do with myself?
I guess you drink it.
I guess we continue this Lord of the Rings video.
Yeah, I mean,
oh god, yeah, we were watching a video.
It's pretty racist so far, and we're about to find out about the atheists.
Oh great! Oh,
boy. That's when all the magic in Middle Earth starts to disappear, because all the world man cares about is building,
we solve the world's problems,
or
yeah,
industry or things you can touch with your hand.
No more magic because we want to build buildings. Okay, well,
chicken doesn't. No, Domino's chicken doesn't go with Domino's Alfredo. Chat. I need to make that clear.
That's pretty bad if you can't make Alfredo and chicken go together.
Well, that's the thing. Domino's. I don't even know why I bothered. Order. Well, no, I ordered from them because I can't order from Pizza Hut.
They closed down in your area.
No, I just have a very bad relationship with the people who work there.
you're running out of pizza places, man. Well,
I heard that they had to close a bunch of stores or some shit. Pizza Hut's losing out to Domino's right now.
Wolf, do you have a Chuck E. Cheese's around you?
Why? Well, first off, no. Second, why would I go to a Chuck E. Cheese?
Because they have Father John's Chuck E. Cheese.
A Father John's, is that near you? Yes.
I just wanted
Father
a.
John.
Oh, Father Jonathan. My
Father
name is
Jonathan.
Father Jonathan.
The pizza man.
Father Jonathan, the pizza man.
I just wanted a pasta. That's all I wanted. And now.
How about your pasta pizza over to me?
Speechless.
I'm having a night. You know, it started great with Tonald, and then he left, and it's like all joy was sapped from the world.
Much like early. The atheist humans of Lord of the Rings sapped the world of magic by creating buildings. Once Tonald left, the stream, stream's magic was sapped.
Because that's how it worked. Yes. And he totally has references for those.
But they lost
the
their
humans are the only good characters.
That's why the elves jump on their boats and bounce the fuck out of there. Jeremy Rollins?
Elves, the Christians.
Exactly, yeah. Divine, perfect beings who only fight when it's absolutely necessary. And at the end of the
Yes, Christians.
Wait, he said only fight when it's absolutely necessary. It's not absolutely necessary for the elves to fight in Helm's Deep. They're doing it to help the men.
Mm-hmm.
What does he mean absolutely necessary, by the way?
Like self-defense?
Yeah, but yeah, because again, the Helm's Deep wouldn't count, surely.
In the movies, when all the other religions of Middle-earth have to go back and scoop up giant mounds of elephant poop or trim the beards of giant wooden tree people, the elves get to move on to paradise. Because they were right all along. Also, Gandalf is straight up an angel sent down from heaven. Read the Silmarillion.
Oh my god, that's about the only accurate thing he said so far.
Yeah, but angels and divine beings sent as agents of a greater, you know, being down to earth, that's not exclusive to Christianity. I don't even know why he brought that
in. A lot of stuff.
Why is this guy saying that he should read the Silmarillion when it's clear he probably just read that on Reddit and put that in the script? He hasn't read Silmarillion, I can guarantee it.
Lies. He probably read the Wikipedia, though.
Or the elves are like Buddhists or Shintoists, because they're a super exclusive group of warriors who only fight when they have to, and they live in a monastery.
There are a lot of waterfalls. Seems vaguely Buddhist.
All the elves' armor and weaponry looks vaguely Japanese, and when they vanquish the ultimate evil,
vaguely Japanese.
To Nirvana.
The band?
No, not the band.
But why would Tolkien, a self-described turbo Christian,
there's no way he said
write
that.
A
Oh,
these two are like the most unfunny people.
This is script.
Have they got a chuckle out of anyone yet?
No.
Even people are scared.
To make laugh too, so
it's hurting my brain.
I literally have a headache. I'm not even kidding. And it only started with this, so it's either because of this or it's because of Wolf talking about the pasta.
I have AIDS now. Man, I don't know if my headache is induced by these two idiots or my Alfredo pasta or both.
Well,
be a
I hate Alfredo.
How much of that 2 liter have you drank so far?
Not much.
You better get on it, man.
Get on that.
Not that
shit.
Then. Drink some more.
I already had a Pepsi before getting this. I'm not thirsty enough to drink 2 liters of cherry.
You don't
Coke.
Have to drink it all at once.
Just hook up an IV.
That's just one cup.
That's why I said I'm not drinking all of it.
Story glorifying Eastern religions.
Oh no! They're not Christians at all. The elves are a super exclusive group of beautiful, wealthy white people who live in a giant temple mansion and follow a leader named Elrond.
Elrond is not their leader. He's like upper management.
And
so he corrects that, but he doesn't correct Tolkien.
Well, this is pain. Like, I don't know what to...
the joke is at the expense... If this is a joke, then it's done at the expense of... something people really like? Or is this like a really 4D chess 5D 12 Connect 4 style of saying that this is actually making fun of people who think the Lord of the Rings is racist because they're trying to make those people seem really crazy? Yeah.
It was very poorly received, and there's shit tons of corrections in the comments. So whatever they tried to do, it didn't work out.
Yeah, if this was supposed to be a parody of people, they failed because they're not funny or intelligent. If this was serious, then it failed because they're not funny or intelligent.
At the end of it, they follow Elrond to space.
What do you know, you person with things, ridiculous things coming out of face? I spent the past 12 goddamn hours watching Lord of the Rings. I am the authority here.
Oh, 12 hours, man. Are you okay?
Yeah, I mean, sure. There's some eye strain and mild light sensitivity.
So you're saying the light hurts us?
No, shut up.
Like it hurts the pressure.
Stop it!
Oh my god.
Okay.
Getting...
Alright.
I'm losing years.
Now I know it's not a joke, because they're failing pretty hard right here, in particular.
Yes, so. This is them trying to be funny! Yeah.
I felt the hair on my arms rise when he did that.
Yes. That hurt, man. Like,
it triggered my gag reflex.
You shouldn't expose people to stuff like this without warning. How fucked up?
I'm pretty sure this video violates the Geneva Convention.
Yeah.
I broke you. It's weird.
Mm-hmm. Wow, I hate it.
Why?
Why? That was Mahler, I'm gonna ask you a personal question.
I didn't do it on Pip. I was
never, ever, ever for any well,
my family had a gun to their head. Okay, that's why I did it.
So they circumcised you because they had a gun to their head.
All of the guns were at all of their heads.
Aside from that, never show me a cracked video ever again for as long as we are friends.
I'll make a note of that myself.
Wolf can't handle that crack.
I mean, that wasn't as bad as Cinema Virgin, but that's only because it was, well, yeah, because it was an hour and 14 minutes shorter.